Good morning, everyone. Today's a big day. I don't know. I think I always say that. Every day is a big day. Let's use it. Today, we are, a shochet is coming. There is a special guy who slaughters the animals, I don't know how to say it in a better way, in the halachic manner. He actually lives in Har Nof. He's coming to us at 10 o'clock. What we're gonna do is we're gonna try to butcher one of our turkeys. So if you're vegetarian or you do not like any of this, I am not gonna show the actual schecting, but we will be schecting one of the turkeys this morning. And I always knew that was the plan. We'd like to schecht the chickens and the turkeys and use them because, you know, happy animals are the best. I wanted to make sure that we can actually eat it, go through with it, and like it. So we're gonna try one. I've never done that before. I've never eaten anything that I grew before either. I think that once it looks like a turkey or once it looks like a chicken from the store, then you sort of disattach. So I don't know. We'll wait and see what happens. That's a new adventure. Okay, what I need is my net just in case. I'm gonna need it to catch the turkey. Setting up our, I think we're gonna schecht in this area here. There's shade here. I brought the stuff that I need. I'm not sure what I need, but I brought buckets, paper towels, some knives, salt, kosher salt, the thicker kind. And let's see. All right, this is our turkey that we chose. I caught him, I forgot to film the catching. I wanted it to be easy as possible, as stressless as possible. So I'm just gonna hold him until the guy comes and then I'll, and then we'll get to it. Okay, in the bag is a turkey.
So.
Okay, I'm gathering, right, you have to cover the blood with earth, so I'm gathering, checking the knife, making sure that it's kosher, the knife. Okay, we're turning away so we don't see. Amen. That's it, it's done. It's the knife. Shochet's knife. Takes very good care of it.
Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu, melech haolam, asher kidshanu, mitzvotav v'tzivanu, ha'kisui gam ba'achronim.
Amen. Next step is to pluck the feathers. It was a lot easier than I thought. The feathers just came right out. Okay, this is how the turkey looks. One second, this is the turkey. We did not take off the feet yet, everything else. We're almost finished plucking, cleaning. We emptied the inside. I did not show you the inside. Feathers that we didn't get the first round. So this is like more of a tedious job. Okay, now of course, kosher wise, we're now gonna soak it in water for an hour. And then after we soak it in water for an hour, then we're gonna salt it. Soaking the chicken in water. The schechting's over, the cleaning's over. Now we just have to salt it and kosher it. Meanwhile, the turkey's soaking in water. And I just wanted to take a minute to explain why we're doing this. So when the shochet came, we asked him, he said, oh, chicken's kosher. I said, but you didn't even open it up. You didn't even check. He said, chickens who run in free range and eat and are taken care of the way you take care of them, you don't even have to check them. Turkeys and chickens that live in closed, confined containers like the commercial ones, then they're sick a lot. They get medicated a lot. And that's where the problems are. I don't want to go into all the details about exactly the problems, then there are so many of them that you have to check this and check that and check this. She goes, look at these lungs. He was like, these are amazing. It's beautiful. And you can tell the turkey was so, so healthy. So it was really nice to hear. There wasn't so much meat on the turkey. He said that we have to fatten them and give them special fattening food, like lots of bread, etc., if we want them to be not so lean. Also, because they can free range, they get more of a muscle mass because they keep on walking and running around, which confined don't. So they don't have so much muscle, and the muscle makes the meat tougher. But we still have another month, so hopefully I'll be getting bread for them, and we'll see if that's a way to go, or I'll see what other options there are to get them fatter. To get them fatter than the free range that we're doing now. How was the experience? I have to say I did get emotional when he did the bracha. I didn't watch the actual schecting part, just the before and the after, which was fine for me. I did get a bit emotional during the bracha. I think it was a very special experience to be able to raise a turkey, have it born on your farm, and then be able to shecht it and make this special bracha in your own backyard is not an experience everyone can do. That was very special for me. Another thing that was crazy, that really threw me, was that I was with someone who was helping me there, and they said that we were gonna give the chickens, the leftovers of the things that we don't eat, the intestines and things. Chickens can eat that, it's all protein for them. So we were gonna give it to them. In the end, by mistake, they put the turkey innards into the turkey coop. And what happened? The turkeys should have gone to eat it, but what happened is that they somehow knew, I don't know exactly how, and they all just stood a meter away from the bowl, and they looked inside, and they started going round in a circle, like around it, looking inside one after the other. I was like, this is like a Leviah, you know? They're like, they realize that, what, I don't know, something they realized that was too much for me. It was a mistake that caused it. It shouldn't have happened, but it did happen, and it was extremely hard to see how they've never done anything like that before. So it was a very, very interesting moment. It was, yeah, very intense. That's a good word, intense moment over there. And other than that, I think this is the way to do it. I like this. I think I can continue growing and shechting here, right here on the farm. I think is best for the animals and best for the people. So I'll show you soon the, oh wait, I forgot to say one more thing. The reason I only shechted one is because I wanted to make sure that we can actually eat it and enjoy it and use it and learn before I'm gonna just shecht all of the 16. That was what today was, a trial run. And after we do the trial run, which went really well, we're gonna learn and we'll learn the process. We're gonna see if we actually like it. If we actually can eat it and we like it, then I'll do more. If we don't, I'm gonna sell them. I don't have to shecht them if we're not gonna be eating them. It's gonna be open to the Neve girls, and whoever wants to see how you kasher stuff is gonna be when we do, if and when we do the rest. So it really depends on the tasting trial. But today is Thursday. So usually I think you should leave it in the fridge for like 24 hours before you cook it. I'm not exactly sure, but that's what I've been hearing. So that would be to cook it tomorrow for Shabbos, but I'm not home for Shabbos. So, and then afterwards is the 9 days. I'm gonna see what to do now, when to cook it and how to cook it. And we'll let you know. Yeah. Okay, steamy. Taking it out of the water, shaking it off of it. Okay. With the egg, filling the hole inside. I have to check that the salt gets to all corners on the inside. So, now it's going to rest. For how long, Rivka?
1 hour.
1 hour. Doing it really well. Ah, that's it? Kosher chicken? Yeah. Kosher chicken? Woo! Kosher turkey! Kosher turkey. Now we just have to go get the little feathers off.